Breaking news tonight, federal prosecutors say that they're going to launch a criminal investigation of the white police officer who shot and killed this man, Kenneth Chamberlain Sr., an African-American retired Marine, inside his own home last November. The federal investigation comes on the heels of a grand jury's decision not to indict the officer. The grand jury's ruling yesterday left many people shaking their heads and many others, including Chamberlain's family, demanding answers. What they want to know is why police officers in White Plains, New York, who were dispatched in the early hours of a November morning to help Mr. Chamberlain, ended up killing him.
Just after 5 a.m., Vietnam vet Kenneth Chamberlain, a 68-year-old African-American man with a severe heart condition, sets off his medical alert device.
Mr. Chamberlain, this is your help center for life aid. Do you need an ambulance, sir?
The operator attempts to talk to him on a two-way speaker in his home.
Mr. Chamberlain, I'm not getting a response. I'm going to notify someone to come by and help you now.
Emergency personnel are dispatched to his apartment to check on him. By 5:30, White Plains police officers are the first to arrive. Chamberlain is now alert and sounds agitated.
I have the White Plains Police Department banging on my door, and I did not call them, and I am not sick.
Everything's all right, sir?
No, it's not all right. I need help. The White Plains Police Department are banging on my door.
Over the next 40 minutes, officers repeatedly try to get him to open the door. Others arrive, including medical personnel and Chamberlain's niece, who also lives in the building.
I don't even think they cared about me because they didn't even acknowledge me.
At 6:13, police turn on a taser, which records this video.
Mr. Chamberlain, leave. I can't leave. We've got to check you out. Leave the knife down. Put the knife down.
Police say he had a butcher's knife in his hand that he stuck through a crack in the door.
Put the knife down and separate the door. Now I'm not asking you, I'm telling you.
Another officer is now standing outside a window in Chamberlain's first floor apartment. The district attorney has confirmed that in a section of the tape not given to CNN, an officer calls Mr. Chamberlain the N-word. Meanwhile, police inside the building are using bolt cutters to get into Chamberlain's apartment. They believe he's used a chair to block the door. At 6:41, more than an hour after they arrived, police finally get Chamberlain's door open. They say he's waving a butcher's knife above his head, and they tase him. Seconds later, they tase him again. At this point, police turn off the taser camera. This is the last image we have of Kenneth Chamberlain alive. Police say he continued to come at them with a knife, so they shot him with several beanbags from a shotgun. Police say when that didn't stop him, one officer had fired his pistol twice. One bullet hit Chamberlain in the lung, killing him. At 7:09 a.m., just about 2 hours after a medical alert dispatcher calls to see if the former Marine is okay, Kenneth Chamberlain is pronounced dead.